the most common from like all the Indian houses.
Yeah, cars are really more compared to all other ones.
Yeah, but it's not more compared. Like it's like if you take one like one car, one bus, like the bus will. Like,
the thing is, if you're using that's a one interesting thing in public transport. Like public transport, all these buses and all the metros. Why we are preferring more that, like more public transport? It means the average occupancy, like if you are serving the cars that is running in Delhi, we can see that almost on an average in one car, we can say like two people, maximum two people. And sometimes we can see one person driving one car. So technically we can say that the people that are carried by 40 cars can be taken in one bus.
Yeah, but like the amount that they put like in the bus here, it doesn't like really depend on the because Delhi's days like it's more work on the buses and like the buses like the buses over here like people like the poor people take the buses, like that's what they say. Okay, I read articles about it. They say that not all the people like can like they really want to take the tram like public transportation, so like it's kind of a like telling the people like that, like convincing the people to do that.
Public transport. So what happened in Delhi is public transport system is there, but the thing is, according Delhi has a population which is almost a 10 million population. Yeah, but the thing is, we don't have enough infrastructure facilities for public transport. That's one of the major issues in Delhi. According to the population of Delhi, we need minimum 11,000 buses in Delhi. But according to the current system, we are just having 5,500.
5,000?
Yes. In Delhi. In our Delhi, including, we have both systems. We have a DTC buses, and then we have cluster. We have seen the orange color buses.
How much then there is how much percent of the population is using buses and other transportation?
Actually, in Delhi, almost 45-50% people are using public transport. Because Delhi is having few category of people who are forced to use this public transport, who are from like a lower income category.
Yeah, it's just because you don't have the money
to own a car. So if people are forced to use this public transport. Though we have this demand, we are not having the infrastructure for that. That's the issue with public transport. It makes all the buses condition. Like condition inside the vehicle is too high. So what happened after that, like the other users who are able to own a car, like they'll definitely own a car, like, because they give preference to the comfort and then the safety.
Yeah.
But some category of people, they give preference to money, which are like low income category of people, which are very predominant in Delhi. They give preference to this public transport because their priorities, like the fair travel. But there is a few category of people who can own a car. Those people are like extremely rich and they'll be owning, like single person will be having 2-3 cars. So that is the issue. So it is very important to give emphasis to this public transport system, which is I mean, not happening today.
And I think we're just about ready.
What's the
yes.
Three cars is like for one bus, right?
Huh.
So he won't really use the three cars at the same time, so it doesn't really depend on the type of cars he has.
No, the thing is in Delhi, particularly in Delhi, actually another issue was like the trip length. Actually, the length of the distance we are traveling is more.
Yeah, but I'm asking like he won't like a one person can't use like three cars at the same time, so it's
no.
Kind of like one car.
Yeah. But still, one car, how much? Like it occupies a space of 23 square kilometers, like for a car. But it's carrying the maximum 4 numbers.
bit more like a maximum. There's like a, yeah.
Takes up
right.
parking too.
Yeah, parking
here. Takes up parking, and another thing is that if you have three cars, if one person sometimes goes there, one person there, and one person there, and sometimes they all meet. If you have one car, you have to count. Fine.
Okay.
Okay, just before we start,
I have a question.
Yeah.
Why has there nothing been done against the cap put on the number of vehicles we have to count?
Excuse me?
Why, like, has there been anything done, like, a cap put on the number of vehicles or cars the family can own?
No. Right now, there's nothing like a capping for the number of cars we can own. The thing is, like, it's upon our capacity. Like, we are able to. There's no capping like that. That's why India, it's very lenient about owning a car and all. And it's the public transport system, the rules are not at all like stringent. It's like it's all relaxed. So that doesn't matter.
And if you did try to do something against that, would the car industry react positively or negatively to that?
For what?
If you put a cap on a number of vehicles.
It's possible. We are possible because our aim is to reduce the number of cars in the world.
So if you people would tell like the amount of like comfort that they have when you drive them a vehicle. So like the buses over here in Delhi, they're not the most comfortable buses in the world, and like, you know, so, a lot of people squeeze inside of it. It's kind of not like so like to maybe improve the amount of people that want the bus, maybe like change the improve the buses and stuff.
I think, can we wait for that question to after, or do you?
Oh,
okay.
Yeah, I'll take the presentation.
Yes.
Yeah. We need to test
ahead. Can you see? So my topic is clean air and sustainable mobility. So hope you understood like clean air, definitely regarding the air pollution that we are experiencing. And sustainable mobility, what is sustainability? It's like we are preserving something, our resources, and we want our resources to be like safe for the next generation come. So that does mean by sustainability. So here the mobility should be mobility which relates to the transportation should be sustainable enough so that all our resources, as in clean air, clean water, the clean atmosphere, all the resources, we are supposed to hand it over to our next generation. So we need sustainable mobility. So air pollution in Delhi. So air pollution actually among the 20 most polluted cities in Asia, like we have the 13 ones in India. Among the 20 most polluted in Asian countries, all the 13 cities are in India, and Delhi is one of the most polluted cities in India. And you all know, like last Diwali, maybe we faced a smog situation here, which was really weird. And that time we have crossed almost 16 times the standard limit of pollution that we can have in Delhi. Because our safe standard, like we are having air quality index, that is a measurement we use to quantify the air pollution. It gives a value of PM2. PM means particulate matter. So if I start with air pollution, like what is air pollution? I mean, our air is getting filled with many particles which are not good for our health. Any respirable particles which are not good for our health. So among that, one of the most important thing is PM2.5. PM2.5 is particulate matter 2.5. That means particulate matter, they are very fine particles which are having the diameter less than 2.5 micrometer. They are very tiny particles. We can't see them with our naked eyes. But it will be present in the atmosphere, and when we inhale it, what happens? They are very small. They can go deep into our lungs. That's why those PM2.5 particles are very dangerous for humans. And this PM2.5 is a particle which have crossed 16 times the standard value during the last pollution. So that's why we said Delhi had a very weird scenario that last November. So from where are this PM2.5 coming? Like we have many sources from where this PM2.5 is coming to the atmosphere. So we can see that the most, like majority of PM2.5, the source road dust, because Delhi, as you all know, like North India here, it's an arid region. Arid region, we are having all of the dust. It's not a like a humid place. It's like a very dry and arid region. So with the geographical conditions, we all have dust. So that dust is a major reason for the pollution first. But in order to reduce the impact, we should have what? We should have reduced the vehicle count. But again, we are having that much amount of height and number of vehicles in the roads. So both of those account for 58% of PM2.5 in the atmosphere of Delhi. So these are the all sources for PM2.5. And per day in Delhi, these sources are emitting 59,000 kilograms of PM2.5 into the atmosphere.
So like compared to another city, is that a lot? Like compared to another city, like London?
Compared to other cities, among the Asian countries, this one is like this one was the highest one. In good aspects, we can say that in Delhi, the exposure to the people, like the thing is, the exposure to the people from this dust is comparatively lower compared to Kolkata. So if you're comparing,
so like my question was like, is Delhi pollution like 10 times higher than pollution in Kolkata, or
no.
Or how, like how much times higher?
In 2014, Delhi was the first one, like the most polluted city in the world, and now it is like in the top 10. It's there in the top 10, but in India we can even find Kolkata, then Gwalior, all those places much more polluted than Delhi in few days, like few months in the, during the festival days, like some, and even Punjab is for crop burning time. So all those cities are having, they are again at the brim of the maximum limit. But as an overall, you know, like if you are going with the annual values, Delhi will be at the highest. Like, but certain days we can see like Kolkata may be higher. Some days, Gwalior, like now, then Punjab may be higher.
Yeah.
Okay, so could you take the map?
A little louder.
Yeah. So like if you take the map of Delhi. You see, Delhi is a huge city, right? It's a very big city. But in the city, there's 22 million people. The population is 22 million. So, in the city, like the people, like there's a huge amount of people that fill the place. So, it's very it's like because of the huge amount of people, it's very full, and like each thing that one person does is very like effective. So, if let's say in a circle, you have 20 people, and like you can fit there 20. So if you can fit 20 in the circle, and every person is doing the same thing as the other person, but so they're all affecting like the other area, and yeah, the area is getting affected. That's what happened in Delhi.
Okay.
So.
But do you have a question? Do you have a question, or is it a statement?
No, it's a question. Right. So yeah, question. So after the circle.
Let him.
Yeah. So Because of that, is it really effective what one person does? Is there a kind of rule what things can do? Doing something in a zone, is there like things that like affect like anything that like they're illegal?
Illegal thing. One among the other major reasons for air pollution we can see is a domestic source. So that's what you mean, like how can we reduce the domestic things for reducing the air pollution, right? That is what you meant? So for that I would say that there are to make a change we should start from the beginning. So if we start from the home, it will make a big difference. It will be small, but when it get compounded with the other, it will be a big change. It could be create a big change. So for that, we have to understand the major sources of air pollution that is coming in. So one of the major reasons is the garbage burning. So if the one person, like even one home, if he take care of managing this, all the waste materials and the dumping and the garbage trash and everything. If we are taking care of the waste coming out of our home, and then if 10 people are doing the same thing, it
yeah.
can make a big difference actually.
So I have a question about the PM2.5. So in other cities, is the cause of PM2.5 also dust?
No.
So it's like a specific problem in Delhi, the dust?
Delhi, the thing is, dust is always a problem. But
yeah.
for Delhi, it's predominant.
Okay.
It's dominating all other sources, that's why.
What do you mean, like, dominating all sources?
Because I told you, Delhi is an arid region. It's like it's a very dry region where we have this dust all over, as in especially we are having more number of vehicles also. It makes the atmosphere always dry and dustier. So that's why we are like Delhi governor was trying all the vacuum cleaning on roads. All those measures were carried out last month. But what happened, it was not that effective. It won't be effective that much. For that we should try from first, like to reduce the road dust, we have to reduce the load coming out of the road. As in, if we reduce the number of vehicles coming off the road, we can manage the roads. So to make the roads more cleaner, like make the roads more greener, like if we are putting more planting things and the trees on the road, it can definitely reduce the dust. So it's like we can't do anything to reduce the dust directly, but indirectly we can reduce it. That's what we can do.
And also, like, I read that Zubal is now the first most polluted city in the world in terms of PM2.5. And Zubal is also, like, sort of like a desert kind of place. So I think, like, are most desert places the most, like, polluted cities in the world?
It's, not exactly.
Okay.
You can't say it like that. It depends on many factors. Dust is just one factor.
Yeah. But it's a lot of stuff.
Yeah, it's 38%.
Yeah.
It's for Delhi. It's 38% in Delhi. It's region specific.
So, like, a couple of years ago, Arvind Kejriwal was about to implement a solution for road dust, and it was vacuuming the roads.
Vacuuming.
So, like, vacuuming the roads will help definitely, but where will they put it? Like in landfills? And if it goes back to the landfills, it will eventually come back in the air and come to roads, which wouldn't help.
Yeah,
so
that's what vacuum cleaning won't help too much.
Yeah.
It can help for like few hours, but again the thing will be back in the action.
Okay.
I think we have a question. Has there anything thought out about the sustainable energy sources here?
Sustainable, yeah. Now we are giving support to electric mobility. So many projects are carrying out to bring up more electric vehicles on board. Even more manufacturers are trying to bring in up like more electric vehicles. So that would create a major change in the air pollution scenario. Like even we have changed from all Delhi. None of the buses in Delhi is running in diesel. All the buses are running in CNG. So all these changes are making few differences. Like if you are checking the temporal data of air pollution, you can see that after 2008 it's actually decreasing, and then it's nowadays it's increasing, but it was decreasing from 2008 to 2011-12. You know what, by 2008 actually, according to the Supreme Court order, all the buses have changed to CNG, all the trucks have changed to CNG. So major pollutant from vehicles is contributed by diesel actually.
Coal plants.
And I'm telling about the transport part. Like compared to the petrol, we are having more pollutants from the diesel. And when Delhi banned diesel, maybe I feel like we have seen a major change in that.
Okay.
So these are the various sources. If you are going to our, first of all, the dump yards. You have seen the dump yards in Delhi, like at many locations, even at Okhla, in Ghazipur. We are having a lot of landfill area in Delhi. So those are what happens in the landfill area. They are depositing all the organic matters. So what happens? The organic matter will get reacted with the oxygen in the air, and then they form methane gas inside. So So then that will like litter the all the waste and it, the fire will come out of it.
Can
you
say that again? I didn't quite understand.
The thing is, about the solid waste, like I'm telling, you may think that like, dumping yards or the landfill area, how can it affect the air pollution? That's what I'm saying. It's like when we are dumping these all the organic waste together, what happens is that these organic waste, they will be leached out of it. Right. When we are dumping all the organic waste together, leachate will come out of it. Like a liquidy kind of a thing will be coming out of the waste. And then these waste will be reacting with the oxygen in the air.
Oh.
And then it will form a methane gas. And this is emitted to the atmosphere. So again, that's the same thing, garbage burning. Even when we are burning the garbages, lot of toxic gases are emitted. Especially when we are burning plastic. So it's high time for Delhi to ban plastic. Many of the cities have already banned this plastic, but still Delhi is having plastic. So it's high time we have to ban plastic. And another thing is diesel. It's actually diesel, definitely, because diesel is one of the like toxic thing. Like it emits most of the toxic gases to the air. But again, Delhi government has done a very weird thing that we are having pollution control methods. Like here we are having, every vehicle is supposed to have a pollution under control certificate, which says that the vehicle is emitting pollution which is under control. But what happened now is the standard for the diesel vehicle is really high. See, we are the smoke coming out of a diesel vehicle, we used to like measure it with smoke unit, which is HSU. That is a smoke unit. So the standard value or the limit of the smog unit in Delhi for diesel has kept 50, which is really high. Really high means it will be emitting black, literally black gas. So it's again high, again the against the government, because the government has to lower that cutoff point. Then only we can reduce the diesel vehicle in Delhi. Excuse me?
If we were to stop burning garbage, how do we dispose of it?
Actually, plastic is the one we can recycle it. We can use it again. For that, another big thing is we initially we have to do segregation of waste. Here in Delhi, we used to dump everything together. Then segregation is not happening. In other hand, if we are putting the waste bins like separately for the plastic, that is non-biodegradable, and then another waste bin for biodegradable things. We have to do it right from the first, the segregation. That is not happening.
If we recycle plastic, why do they have to ban it?
Because if we are not banning it, people will definitely use it. But the recycling, it has many limitations, because we have seen now also, like if we are controlling a little bit, then we can put those restrictions. But even if we are not controlling at all, if we are not putting any control upon this plastic wala things, then at the end, the overall recycling is not possible. We have to put some restrictions, and then the putting restriction doesn't mean that plastic won't be there at the city. There will be plastic, but we are putting restrictions upon that. Then we can do the recycling of the rest of the plastic. Without putting a ban, like without having any limitations, and then we are allowing all the plastics in for recycling, it won't make any difference. So then the industries and the cost of construction, Delhi is facing a lot of construction projects, and this construction again, is emitting a lot of dust on the Delhi air.
I read that there was a report and it had the 16 countries with the biggest economies in the world. And it said of all of those that Delhi had the most, or India had the most energy efficient transportation. But also of those 16, it was the most polluted. So is there a relationship between those two things? Because it doesn't make sense that those two would be for the same country.
Delhi is having the most energy efficient vehicles here, but again we are having the most polluted scenario. That's what you're asking.
Yeah.
Because I already told you, Delhi is having a predominant sector of people who are like forced to use the public transport. Like the captive users. We say captive users. They are, the people who are forced to use a thing are called captive users. So Delhi is having a predominant amount of captive users for public transport, and again the rickshaws and the cycles and everything. But still, in the same amount, we are having the other sector also. That's true. You did?
Yeah.
So that's what we are asking, no?
Yeah.
So we are having, it won't make a difference, because though we are having the electric vehicles, or though we are having the energy efficient vehicles in Delhi, like we are having more number of cars compared to that.
Right.
Though we are having the energy efficient thing, we are having the other petrol and the diesel, like private vehicles more. It's not like we are having energy efficient vehicles compared to the private vehicle. We are not having energy efficient vehicles compared to the private cars. Compared to other cities, we are having more energy efficient vehicles. But if we are comparing within Delhi, this energy efficient vehicles are comparatively lesser compared to the private vehicles.
Thank you.
Wait, so it's sort of like because Delhi has so many people and like compared to other countries in the world, it's like almost, it has like the population of all like a country, like almost. So, yeah. And like, so is that the reason why like it can be like the most polluted city in the world?
Delhi, it's actually regarding the urban development of, like the urban planning of Delhi. Planning is in such a way that the average kilometer, average distance traveled by a person in Delhi is almost maybe 10 kilometers. It shouldn't be like that, because of the urban planning thing. Like people will be staying in one location where the air is good, and people will be working in some other location. In other cities, like other cities in India, we can see the average trip length is near to 5 kilometers, 6 kilometers. But coming to Delhi, it becomes 10 kilometers. So the vehicle emissions from this 10 kilometers is comparatively higher than that. So, as in that is a major relationship between the trip length, that we say the trip length from the home to where he or she is going. So, as the trip length increases, what happens? The emissions also increase. For Delhi, according to the planning of Delhi, the trip length is really high. It's more than 10 kilometers. So, again, that includes the emissions of vehicles. And the emissions of vehicles will be more than that, and the congestion will be more. And again, for Delhi, another thing is the close connectivity is bad, actually. If you want to go from one place to another, it's like the connectivity is comparatively broken in some ways. Like, if you're having one residential location here and another residential location here, we may be having a major road, but we are not having the internal connectivity. So the roads are not in a... If you can take the Google Earth map, you can see for US and for other European countries, see that all the streets are close connected, but for Delhi it's not like that. It's organically developed, and we are not imposing any principles upon it, and the roads are not close connected. So then the trip length increases, and so it's not just the height in the population, it's not about the population, it's just about the trip length we are achieving, and then what else, the vehicles we are using. Delhi, another thing is the average age of vehicle is really high. People are using, you can see the Delhi buses, they are really poor.
Yeah.
So, and Delhi government is not at all procuring any more buses, and according to current statistics, by 2027, if you're not buying any more buses, by 2027, our bus count will be zero. Because all the bus will be scrapped out. Because our average age of a bus is 12 years. After 12 years, after manufacturing, the buses will be scrapped out. So, and Delhi is not procuring any more buses. And we are actually running the old buses. And as the age increases, what happens? The emission god is like, it's not like, the emission from a new car is really, if the same model, if the car is 2 year old or 3 year old, the emission god has a difference.
That's why they did the thing with the
diesel,
it's like more than 10 years.
Like, as the year goes, the emission also will get changed.
Yeah.
Can I sort of, so what I'm hearing is that it's this question about efficiency versus pollution is an interesting kind of thing, and I think it can be confusing. But so what I'm hearing is that, for one thing, even though overall, because a lot of people ride the buses and take public transportation and ride cycles because that's the way they need to get to work, overall, that's more efficient, right? But there's still like another, it's almost like there are two cities in Delhi. There's the city in Delhi where people are doing things very sustainably, which is most of the city. And then there's a smaller city, like people like us, often, who are driving a lot of cars, and those cars are less efficient and more polluting. Is that, that's part of it? And the city isn't really designed very well for those cars. Is that, so there's that second, that small city, which includes us, is polluting more. But then, of course, transportation is only one part of the whole pollution, as you've been saying, right? So we could solve transportation, we still have to solve these other things.
Sort of four quarters. We can say vehicles and the transportation is one part. The second will be the industries and all. And then the third part will be the garbage. Garbage and the garbage burning in Delhi. And the four will be the other components. Other components means all the household things and all the domestic, and then here we have already seen. See, if we are cooking in our home, even that emit pollutants. So all these small sources and the road test. So if you have, these are the main four sources for the air pollution in Delhi: vehicle, the road test, then the industries and construction, and then the other few small sources. So these are the major components of air pollution. I already told you, air pollution is like air is getting filled with other particles which are unhealthy for us. So we can have PM2.5, that is a particulate matter which is having a diameter lesser than 2.5 micrometer. And then PM10 is, which is having the, they are also again fine particles, but the diameter will be less than 10 micrometer, but higher than 2.5. So these two are the particulate matter, these two are the most dangerous parts of air pollution, which is really high in Delhi. And then other than that, we are having other gases actually, sulfur dioxide, and then nitrous oxide, then carbon monoxide, ozone, benzene, all these are gases, these are again, but all the gases are having values within a safe limit in Delhi. Actually in Delhi, the major pollutants are like particulate matter. So again, for other sources, we can see the benzene. You can smell it, like you've been to petrol pumps and all. You can smell something. Well, that does the benzene. Like benzene will be emitted from the diesel cars more. And another really bad thing about benzene is benzene will get diluted with our blood. So it will become carcinogenic after this. So these are the major pollutants. And last smoke time, like we have seen, benzene level also higher than the standard level. Usually benzene always stood below the standard level, but during the last meters, even the benzene level was higher than the standard. And then these are the various like impact of all these pollutants in our body. So how they are like PM2.5 will be affecting our liver, then fibrosis and our lungs and everything. And then if you are taking SO2, CO2, ozone, and PM2.5, you can cause stroke, and then you can experience it. Like you are already experienced with that air pollution scenario that happened last year. Then this is what Delhi is today. Delhi has become India's asthma capital because people, according to the latest report coming out in India, in every minute, as in two people are losing their death because of air pollution. I mean, death is happening every minute, maybe two deaths is happening because of air pollution. And in a year, we are facing 10 lakh death in India. And in overall, like globally saying, 18,000 people are dying every day because of air pollution. So these are the few facts about Delhi air pollution that what we had. And if your children are always like very sensitive, so we can say like all, if you are taking a child, children, if you are taking children, every third child will be having some issue with the lungs because of this air pollution. So that's how weird Delhi's air pollution is. And one of the other major threat is our car, definitely our car. So this is about sustainable mobility I'm going on. So mobility means it's not just cars. These are not made for cars. That's the first thing you have to see. But if you're going to Delhi roads, we can see it's just cars. Like all the, this will be, it's a Delhi road actually. It's a picture from one of the streets in Delhi.
Talk to the person that like lives like next to us, it's a neighbor. And he told us, I asked him like, well, why are you going like in the bike? So he told me like, I prefer to use a bike because like, the bike is like the best like transportation usage in Delhi. So like, the last vehicle that you can ride. Maybe not the safest, but like
Because bikes are more manageable. We can take it, even if the roads are blocked, we can take it in between the cars. So people are preferring bikes and that. What is dangerous?
I think people don't ride bicycles in Delhi because like, it's so dangerous to ride a bicycle. You get hit by a car.
There are many reasons for people not using bicycles. Because one thing, it's not safe. Like the Delhi Mail, we are having wide roads. Especially in central Delhi, we are having wide roads. The wide roads always tend the drivers to speed up their car. If you are seeing a wide road, definitely we'll again drive at higher speed. So again, that create it makes a cyclist vulnerable to accidents more. That is one reason. And another one is though Delhi is having cycle track, this cycle track is not continuous.
Yeah.
At one point it will get stopped, and then it will be like all these vehicles will be, all the cycles will be merged with the other traffic. Again, it will be like accident prone. And then if we want to use something, see, if we are going somewhere, if the roads are not continuous, we won't take the car. The same way, the Delhi cycle tracks are not continuous. Cycles are not much used here. That's a major reason. And again, the condition, the maintenance thing is really bad here because the Delhi people or the authorities won't maintain the infrastructure in a better way.
And also, do you think that people will start using
Definitely, if you're providing a street design, which is like continuously done, and then if you're providing all the facilities, people will definitely use. Because you can see all the cycle tracks in Delhi. Those cycle tracks was done during the Commonwealth times. Because in 2010, Delhi was a venue for Commonwealth Games.
Yeah.
So that time, Delhi government was forced to develop all the streets and everything and with all the facilities. Only because of that, all these cycle tracks and that came in the central Delhi. And if you're going to North Delhi or the South Delhi, you won't find this. It's just for the central Delhi part, just because 2010 the Commonwealth Games came in India. So if you're thinking about mobility, we have to think about the space to walk, space to cycle, then safety on the roads, that is safety for the pedestrians. And then another question is, are your cities based on men meant for vehicles? It's not. So we should realize that our cities are not just for vehicles. So these are again few facts. These are the users I already told you about the captive riders. As in Delhi, 41% of the people moves like by walking or by using rickshaws. You already told, na, like the electric vehicles are more in Delhi, like energy efficient vehicles are more in Delhi. That's one. Even the statistics says that almost 41% of the total population of Delhi are using the footpath and then the NMT. NMT is non-motorized transport, which includes cycles, electric rickshaws and all. But though 41% of people are using these things. They are just using because they are giving preference to the money, and they are from the low income category of the society, and they are forced to use it. And all are if you are taking our roads, only 40% of the roads, right? Actually 40% of the road doesn't have any facility for this cyclists and the footpath, like all the pedestrians and all. So that's why we are having a growth which is vehicle oriented. That's what we are facing today. All our development is actually vehicle oriented. As in, we are not providing much facilities. We are not providing equitable provisions for the pedestrians and the bicycle users, bicycle and the electric rickshaw users. And you can see, like, if you're seeing the statistics, you can see Delhi is a metropolitan city, and 21% of the total area of Delhi is in the Delhi roads, which is the largest in India. None of the other cities have this much road networks, but Delhi is having 21% of the land covered under roads. But still, we are facing issues with the congestion and the traffic issues. That is just because of the influx of cars. So that's what I'm saying. In Delhi, we have almost reached the maximum capacity of roads we can have. Now it's our duty to reduce the number of cars and make it fixed for our road capacity we have. And for reducing the cars, what we can do is we can promote the public transport. But right now what is happening is we are not promoting public transport, but again we are buying more and more cars into the scene of congestion. So again it's becoming a weird scenario. So this is these are the various photographs from Delhi, the deaths and just because of the traffic. And then therefore, because of the vehicular emissions, we can see from the the pollution concentration of the air, we are inhaling us 3 to 4 times higher than the ambient air pollution. It was 16 during the Diwali time last year, but in an overall, it's 3 to 4 times the actual quality we are supposed to maintain for our air. Then another thing is, Delhi is already a densely populated city. Another thing is, if we are living close to the roads, we are exposed more to the vehicles, like the vehicle emissions. So in that case, we are supposed to maintain some neighborhood development, which is absent in Delhi. Neighborhood means we can have small patches of settlements where vehicles are not allowed, but the parking spaces are there, and then the rest of the roads are just for the pedestrians and the cyclists, and it will be a residential area. So that kind of proper planning things are really lacking in Delhi. And then all the toxic gases, all the air pollution is not just affecting us, it's affecting the future generation also. It's affecting the kids who are going to feed them actually. And then this is what I told. If you're comparing, this is the number of cars which can take almost how many people? 50 people. So it's if you are, this is the number of people, and these number of people can be accommodated in one bus. So we can compare the space they require.
Actually, it's not 100% yet. I think my homie is can I say common? It has to be a question.
Yeah,
you
ask
you. I don't think that in one car, two people, are in, when I go, home, from the main road, and you see cars that, 4 or 5 people are going inside.
Yeah, but here we're telling, there are cases in which cars may have 4 to 5 people in them. But there are cases where cars are having one person. So if you're taking the average value, we can't always take the maximum. There is a minimum and then there is a maximum. So the minimum can be one person, the maximum can be 5 to 6 persons. And from the surveys done, we have found out the average value for the people occupied in the car is 1.2 in Delhi. That is the average occupancy of a car is 1.2. So if we are calculating with that value, then we can say that a bus can carry the people who are carried by 14 cars on an average. It's not like all of these cars are carrying the maximum number of people. Some cars may be carrying 1 person, some may be carrying 2, some may be carrying 3, but some may be carrying 6. But on an average, we can say that the people carried by these many cars can be taken in the bus.
Yeah, but there's one person for one car, or there's one person for one car.
But it's just the average, though.
So just the average value.
In average per car, there's 1.2 citizens. So it's the average. But there's about 5 minutes left. I don't know if you have anything you really want to get like hours, or maybe that's a good time.
So this is like what we are looking. This is what is happening in Delhi. This is what we require. It's from the actual standards and everything. Like from the standards, we are supposed to have all the facilities in roads. As in, we should have facilities for metro. We should have facilities for pedestrians. We should have facilities for cycle tracks. We should have pedestrians for like the seating spaces and everything. This is called the complete design of a street. We are supposed to have these kind of complete streets everywhere, but what we are experiencing today is the upper one, like the upper one.
Can I ask, what is there anything being done right now to reach that goal?
Actually, in Delhi, not in Delhi, for all of India, we are having a code of a manual for the design of streets, that is the Indian Road Congress. Indian Road Congress gives all the codes and manuals for how to design a street. If it is an arterial road, it has certain specifications like how much space shall be given for pedestrians, how much space shall be given for vehicles. On a thumb rule, we can say that on a road, 50% of, like if it is a 24-meter road, 50% of the space shall be given for the vehicles. But the rest of the 50% shall be given for all other facilities, all the street vending, pedestrian, cycles. But actually it's not happening. But right now we are revising all those manuals, and Abhi, we are like imposing that rules on the roads, but it's on the process right now. It's under revision, that code is under revision.
Well, earlier in the year, I heard from when the 500,000 bills were canceled, that the majority of Delhi's population doesn't pay taxes. Do you think if the population, like almost everyone did pay taxes, that the Delhi roads and all that, it would be a lot better and we wouldn't have as much of a problem here?
Population is it can affect. Like if the population is reduced, then Delhi roads will be good, definitely. But that is not a solution.
I think what you're asking is that, is there any money for there? Because so many people are not paying taxes. The government, do they have the money to do this?
Right now, government has a project called Amrut. Amrut is Atal Mission for the Urban Transformation and Regeneration. So in that project, government has found out few cities, and like more than 100 cities who are happy. What they are doing is, they are funding, and they are finding out, they have put an authority to find out the like vulnerable sector in the area. As in, for some cities it may be the transport, for some cities it may be the solid waste management, for some cities it may be sanitation. So for the development of that part of the city, the central government will be funding. So there are many programs like that. It's not just like if you want to do something and government will be giving us money. It's like government will be announcing many schemes for that, and within that scheme, if we are developing our city, then they'll be funding. So that's how it is being done in our country.
I used to ask, where does all the money go?
All the money?
Yeah. So what does the city invest in?
Actually, the thing is, you can see in Delhi, government is investing so much for Delhi Metro. So what is happening here is, they are just developing the metro, but they are not looking at the rest of the part. That's why at the end, everything becomes a mess. See, if we are developing something, we should develop in a holistic way. As in, we have to include everything. See, if you are developing a metro corridor, if you are doing some development kind of, like here in Delhi, they are getting the money for developing the metro. So they are building up the metro. But they are not developing the areas adjacent to that. So at the end, what happens is the metro again, it will become a fail. See, for making one thing success, all the complementary things should be there. That is what is happening in Delhi. Though we are funding a lot, at the end, it won't give that success back, or it won't give the result back in a proper way, because the rest of the part is unattended.
I think maybe one last question.
All the money that the Prime Minister is getting now from the people, exchanging money. So, what's his plan? Or what is he going to do? Is he going to invest all of it in the metro? Or is he going to, try and make the roads better with the money he saves?
No, it depends on, you've seen the budget of Delhi, right? budget, like they'll be allocating money. Like every year, they'll be announcing the budget, Indian budget. So this may they'll be allocating this much of amount of transport for the transport sector. This much, they'll be different here, like this much of amount for the women's safety, this much of amount for the sanitation and solid waste management. So that amount will be granted from the government every year. So then we have to, then the transport department, they'll be allocating this money for various projects according to the priority.
And like if they do like invest it into making the roads better, like how long would it have
better city to a better city. Actually, it depends on the way we are going. See, I told you about the Commonwealth case.
Yeah.
All of those things happened in 2-3 months because that was an emergency case.
So yeah.
Everything happened so quickly here.
So maybe if the government treats like everything as an emergency case, then they can
definitely do it in a faster way. If there is a, for them, if there is a need, they'll do.
Yeah.
But it's like we can't say how much time it will take. It's depending upon the authority who is on the ground. The way he is pushing the people to do what, pushing the law authorities to do. But definitely we can expect something in a near soon.
Thank
not
you.
In the year.
Thank you so much. I think that's all the time we have. But I know that we just want to say thank you. We have a little bit time for some report. Yeah, thank you so much. Can we give it a round of applause? Very informative. Thank you so much. Is there any just final things that you've been keeping inside or no? All right. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.